Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. In this video, we are going to study chylomicron metabolism. Before going to this chylomicron metabolism, I highly recommend to watch these two videos in order to understand basics. First, under lipid chemistry, you can watch lipoproteins where we can understand different classes of lipoprotein and their general structures. And today in this video, we are going to study about chylomicron metabolism. So in order to understand how chylomicron is formed, so you need to watch digestion and absorption of lipids under digestion and absorption playlist, where I have explained after digestion how this chylomicron is formed in the intestinal mucosal cell. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for future notification. So the chylomicron metabolism, we know that chylomicron is synthesized from the intestinal mucosal cell after dietary lipids are digested and absorbed into the intestinal mucosal cell, where they produce chylomicron and it will be released into the lymphatics, and through thoracic duct it will reach circulation. Now this chylomicron, which is present in the circulation, which is synthesized by small intestinal mucosal cell, and the major apolipoprotein present in the chylomicron is B48. Apoprotein B48 is the major apolipoprotein present in the chylomicron, because the site of synthesis of B48 is in the intestinal mucosal cell. As I mentioned earlier, the metabolism of chylomicron means it is metabolism of dietary lipids after digestion and absorption. Because after digestion and absorption of lipids, dietary lipids are converted to chylomicron in the intestinal mucosal cell. And this pathway is also known as extrinsic pathway or exogenous pathway. The chylomicron, which is synthesized by intestinal mucosal cell, is called nascent chylomicron. The newly synthesized chylomicron from the intestinal mucosal cell and released to lymphatics, thoracic duct and the circulation, then it is called nascent chylomicron, where it has got apolipoprotein B48 and a small amount of apolipoprotein A. So when it is synthesized from the intestinal mucosal cell, it has got apolipoprotein A1, because A1 is synthesized from the intestinal mucosal cell and liver. Other A subtypes are acquired from the liver through the circulation. And once this nascent chylomicron present in the circulation, it acquires two apolipoproteins from the HDL. They are apolipoprotein E and apolipoprotein C2. It acquires C1, C2, C3, but here I have mentioned C2 because it plays a very important role in chylomicron metabolism. So these two apoproteins received from the HDL through the circulation, which are originally synthesized by the liver. Now this nascent chylomicron is called mature chylomicron. So once it acquires apolipoprotein C2, there is an enzyme called lipoprotein lipase. Again, this is a very important enzyme. It is an isoenzyme of lipase. This enzyme usually present in the walls of blood vessels or capillaries, attached to endothelial layer of the capillaries, held by proteoglycans of heparin sulfate. Before going further, in order to study chylomicron metabolism, we need to know something about this enzyme because lipoprotein lipase plays a major role in chylomicron metabolism. So after studying about this enzyme, then we will move on to further fate of this chylomicron. This apolipoprotein C2, which is acquired by this nascent chylomicron through the circulating HDL, activates lipoprotein lipase. Remember, lipoprotein lipase present in the walls of the blood vessels, but it is in inactive form. When this mature chylomicron, that is, when it acquires ApoC2 from the HDL, it stimulates or activates this enzyme, lipoprotein lipase. So we will see the action of lipoprotein lipase. Here I have triacylglyceride. Okay. So the dietary lipid, 80 to 90% of our dietary lipid is comprising of triglycerides. And even the major component of chylomicron is triacylglycerides or triglycerides. As we know, triglyceride means, tri means three, acyl means fatty acid. So it has got three fatty acids, fatty acid 1, 2 and 3 attached to glycerol backbone. So this is our triglyceride. Remember, 80 to 85% of dietary lipid is triglyceride. So when we say metabolism of chylomicron, indirectly we are talking about metabolism of triglycerides because it is major component of chylomicron. This triglyceride present in the chylomicron hydrolyzed or catabolized or metabolized by an important enzyme lipoprotein lipase, which is present in the walls of the blood vessels. This lipoprotein lipase is activated by apolipoprotein C2, which is acquired by nascent chylomicron through the circulating HDL. So this ApoC2 is activator of lipoprotein lipase. Once lipoprotein lipase is activated, it will start hydrolyzing these triglycerides present in the central dense core of chylomicron. But this lipoprotein lipase has got specificity to cleave fatty acid attached to carbon number 1 of the glycerol and the carbon number 3 or fatty acid attached to third carbon atom of glycerol backbone. So initially it will cleave fatty acid one by one attached to carbon number 1 and carbon number 3. So lipoprotein lipase removes one fatty acid at a time. Initially it removes fatty acid attached to the carbon number 1 of the glycerol backbone. Again, it can cleave fatty acid attached to the third carbon atom of the glycerol backbone. Now, this lipoprotein lipase cannot cleave fatty acid attached to the second carbon atom of the glycerol backbone. But there is an enzyme called isomerase. It can change the position of fatty acid attached to carbon number 2 of glycerol to either to the first carbon atom of glycerol or to the third carbon atom of the glycerol. So now fatty acid is again attached to carbon number 1 of the glycerol, so that now this lipoprotein lipase can cleave or break this fatty acid. Now by the action of lipoprotein lipase, we have three fatty acids and this triglyceride will become glycerol. Okay, you need to understand the action of lipoprotein lipase, which is present in the walls of the capillaries. So with this knowledge, we will study the further fate of chylomicron. Now this apolipoprotein C2 activates lipoprotein lipase. As we studied just now, this activated lipoprotein lipase acts on the triglycerides which are present in the central dense core of chylomicron. Because the majority of lipids in chylomicron is triglycerides. So start hydrolyzing the triglycerides. As we studied, this lipoprotein lipase removes fatty acids from the triglycerides by hydrolysis of triglycerides. So it will start removing fatty acid one by one, and the glycerol will be taken to liver, where it can be used for synthesis of triglycerides or gluconeogenesis. Now this fatty acids, which are hydrolyzed by lipoprotein lipase, is taken to adipose tissue or extrahepatic tissue or peripheral tissues. So by this way, our lipoprotein lipase hydrolyzes lot of triglycerides present inside the inner core of chylomicron. Now our chylomicron will become small. Please appreciate the size of the chylomicron, that is mature chylomicron, and this chylomicron. Size reduced because by the action of lipoprotein lipase. So here initially it is 80 to 90% of chylomicron is triglyceride. Now about 40 to 50% of triglycerides are hydrolyzed by the action of lipoprotein lipase. Now we have a smaller chylomicron, and this chylomicron handovers its apolipoprotein A to the circulatory HDL. So the HDL plays very important role, because it acts as a repository for apolipoproteins. Even apolipoprotein C2 also received by circulating HDL from the chylomicron. Now this chylomicron is called chylomicron remnant, because about 40 to 50% of triglycerides present in the mature chylomicron are hydrolyzed, and its size is reduced to this much size. And this chylomicron, which is present in the circulation, is called chylomicron remnant. What is the fate of this chylomicron remnant? This chylomicron remnant taken by liver by a process called receptor mediated endocytosis. That means, in the liver, there is a specific receptor to internalize or for the endocytosis of this chylomicron remnant. Remember, this receptor is recognized by apolipoprotein present on the surface of chylomicron remnant. The name of this receptor is called LRP. The full form of LRP is LDL receptor related protein. It belongs to LDL receptor family, and its structure is almost similar to LDL receptor. It recognizes apolipoprotein E and B48. The majority of chylomicron remnants are taken to the liver through this LRP or LDL receptor related protein. But smaller amount of chylomicron remnant could be taken by this receptor, which is mainly a receptor for LDL or low density lipoprotein. Even this LDL receptor can take this chylomicron remnant through receptor mediated endocytosis. LDL receptor mainly recognizes B100 present in the LDL, but since B100 and B48 belongs to same family of apolipoprotein, but their site of synthesis is different, and it can recognize ApoE also. By this way, whatever dietary lipids are finally taken to liver, where it could be further metabolized by hepatic lipase and cholesterol esterase. So the summary: chylomicron is a lipoprotein which is synthesized from the intestinal mucosal cell after digestion of dietary lipids. And this chylomicron released into the lymphatics, then to the thoracic duct, then it will reach circulation, where it acquires apolipoprotein E and C from circulating HDL. Once it acquires apolipoprotein C2, it will activate lipoprotein lipase present on the walls of capillaries, and once it is activated, it can hydrolyze about 40-50% of triglycerides present inside the central dense core of chylomicron, and the fatty acids are deposited in the adipose tissue or extrahepatic tissue or peripheral tissue. So now the remaining part of chylomicron is called chylomicron remnant after handover ApoA and ApoC2 to the circulating HDL. This chylomicron remnant taken to the liver or uptake by the liver through two receptor family, that is LRP and LDL receptor. This is with respect to metabolism of chylomicron or exogenous pathway or extrinsic pathway, or in other words, metabolism of dietary lipids. Thanks for watching.